Good evening, and welcome to the Board of Selectmen meeting of April 11th, 2013. Welcome, Greg, come on in. We have an agenda that's posted this evening, but I have an announcement to make on behalf of Selectman Joe Milliken first, if I may read his statement. After considerable reflection, I have decided to offer my resignation, effective April 12th, 2013, as a member of the Board of Selectmen, Dover Board of Selectmen. This action is being taken for two reasons. First, my limited ability to attend regular meetings and my ongoing difficulties in attending numerous other monthly and special meetings. Second, to allow a new member, after a special election, to serve a full year as a selectman before his or her re-election. During the past 16 years, I have participated in 32 years of elected or appointed offices, with 5 years on the Board of Selectmen, 6 years on the Warrant Committee, 2 years as chairman, 16 years as the town's representative on the MBTA Advisory Board, and 6 years as the town's representative on the Metropolitan Area Planning Council. I have thoroughly enjoyed the opportunity to serve the town. Thank you, Joe Milliken. Well, I read that with sadness, quite honestly. Joe's taught me a lot, and the town has been served very, very well by Joe. And I will personally miss him and professionally miss him. Carol, would you like to add anything?
Sure. Well, certainly reiterate your remarks as well. I first got involved with Joe when he joined the Warrant Committee in 2002. So we've been working together in various capacities as Warrant Committee members or selectmen for 10 years now. And he brings a wealth of information. He's always been a pleasure to work with. And when I chatted with Joe last week, I had hoped that he'd be able to come to the meeting tonight so that we can watch him blush as we said thank you and said wonderful things about him. But obviously he could not make it tonight. So Joe, I hope you're listening, and I hope you're blushing. And thank you from all of us, and we'll miss you. And we hope that you'll still be available for your counsel.
Thank you, Carol. Well, unfortunately, we have to go to regular business now. And the first item agenda is to sign the 2013 annual town election warrant. Our elections are on Monday, May 20th, from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. at the Dover Townhouse. And should I read off the elected positions, or
you may, or it's your discretion, Mr. Paul.
Carol, how would you do it?
We might as well just go over that, sure.
Sure, great, thank you. Okay, in this particular town election, which is Article 24, and the following positions are going to be decided: moderator for 1 year, Board of Selectmen for 3 years, a member of the Board of Assessors for 3 years, 2 members of the Dover School Committee for 3 years, 1 member of the Dover-Sherburn Regional School Committee for 3 years, 2 members of the Board of Library Trustees for 3 years, 1 member of the Cemetery Commissioners for 3 years, a member of the Planning Board for 5 years, 1 member of the Board of Health for 3 years, 2 members of the Park and Recreation Commission for 3 years, and 3 constables for 3 years. In addition to those elected positions, we will have a question, which is the non-binding question regarding the Dover Park and Recreation, and I'll read it so there's no confusion. This question is not binding. Shall the Dover Park and Recreation Commission be advised to proceed with current plans to construct additional athletic fields at Carroll Park, provided such construction is funded only with donated monies and requires no funding from taxes or from the Park and Recreation Revolving Fund? And that is a yes or no question. I mentioned that the polls open at 7 o'clock in the forenoon and will close at 8 o'clock in the evening. Okay. And that is our annual town election warrant. Do we have to approve it or by motion or to sign?
Vote to execute.
Carol?
I move that we vote to execute the warrant.
I'll second that. All in favor? Aye. Thank you. Thank you, Greg. Okay, next item that we're going to discuss but was not on the agenda setup is the special town election warrant. Now, as everyone possibly is aware, that on Tuesday, June 25th, 2013, we'll have a special town election for the United States Senate seat of John Kerry. On that same day, Dover will have a special town election to replace Mr. Malkin's position as a Board of Selectmen. So that'll be on June 25th, 2013, from 7 a.m. to 8 p.m. in the Dover townhouse, excuse me. Now, there are specifics to that, and thank you. On this special election for Mr. Malkin's seat or position, we will sign the special election warrant this evening, which will also serve as a notice of election of the town clerk on tomorrow, April 12th, 2013. On April 19th, the warrant will be mailed to all the households. On April 24th, the town clerk will hold a town caucus for this position. On May 7th, 2013, will be the last day to submit nomination papers for certification by a registrar of voters. On May 25th, will be the last day to file certified nominating papers with the town clerk. And as I said, June 25th, 2013, the special election will be held simultaneous with the special state election. So those are the specifics of this special election for Mr. Malkin's seat. And we have to vote to approve that also. So I'll make a motion that we approve the special town election warrant for June 25th, 2013.
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Thank you.
Same as the normal caucus that's held in March, which is will be held in the Great Hall. And anyone who's interested in being nominated either needs to appear or have a representative appear and put their name into nomination. But for those who don't go through the caucus nomination process, there is the nomination papers process, the same as in March. And I believe all this is going to be put on the website.
Yes, good. Thank you for that clarity.
Oh, and also, so you're going to be receiving in a period of about 2 weeks, depending on how the mail works, two warrants. And, you know, they're the white 8x10 things. And this was the warrant for the annual town meeting. So this shape. And we'll be receiving two, so please don't think that the second one is just a duplicate of the first. One is for the town meeting, town election on May 20th, and the other one is for the special town election on June 25th.
Good, thank you. Okay, I believe that's it as far as the special elections and annual town elections. Thank you for that. Our next agenda item is to finalize article motions. This is our second review of article motions, I believe. And as far as I know, since we last spoke to this, only article 12, which is a citizen's petition, has changed. And prior to about a couple hours ago, new wording was sent in and was approved by the petitioners. And is different wording than the blue book, which has been printed, Mr. Cohen?
It is at the printers, as we speak, yes.
Be mailed out tomorrow or shortly thereafter?
I'm not sure if you're calling that tomorrow.
I believe tomorrow.
Thank you.
So there will not be an opportunity to revise the blue book. And the warrant committee will handle this in the ways that they deem appropriate. Now, the petitioner at the warrant committee open hearing had mentioned this article would likely be amended to narrow the scope and increase the monetary value, and the new wording is the result of that. Now, I don't know how much I want to get into this new wording that is written on the articles, because I believe there's yet been another new set of verbiage that arrived this afternoon that's been sent to town council. I have not seen it, so I can't speak to it. Carol, can you add anything to that?
Well, I think I haven't seen it either, but I believe it's just a question of whether this would be a bylaw.
Correct.
Right?
Okay.
So I guess I would suggest that we read this.
Good, thank you.
I think the content's the same. It's just the governing formality of it.
Good, then I'll read the citizen's petition as I know it today. And I'll read it from the petitioner's voice. I move that prior to commencement of any project on town-owned property in the custody of the Park and Recreation Commission, for which half or less of the cost, including the value of in-kind donations, is to come from town appropriations, A, proper plans, specifications, and estimates of the probable expense be submitted to the Board of Selectmen for review, and B, town meeting approval is required for any of said projects projected by the Board of Selectmen to cost in excess of $150,000, including the value of any in-kind donations. So that is the citizen petition as written that I know of right now. And again, it's a change from the blue book, and the warrant committee will figure out what to do on that part. Okay. Anything else? No? Carol, anything? Okay. So we just set this aside for now and go on to other matters? Okay. Thank you. So the next agenda item is to discuss the Ruth Pfeiffer Scholarship. Good. Who would like to discuss the scholarship?
Well, I can talk about it since I've had the privilege of giving it out for the last couple of years at the selection. So the Ruth Pfeiffer Scholarship is given every year at awards night in late May or June to a senior, male or female, who exemplifies scholarship and athletics and community service, and it's been quite awe-inspiring to see the biographies of the winners over the last 4 or 5 years. But Ruth Pfeiffer set up the scholarship a while ago. I believe there's $20,000 principal. And then we have had to, over the last couple of years, decrease the amount of the scholarship due to the lower earnings and interest rates, because we cannot touch the principal. So back in 2007, 2008, and 2009, we were giving $1,000 to the award winner. And then in 2010 and 2011, we decreased it to $750. That was still way above the interest earned for the previous year, so we were still reducing the balance available to us. In 2012, this past June, we voted and reduced it to $500. And here we sit today, I guess that's still the question, right?
I remember the discussion last year for the reason reducing it, and it made sense.
So we currently have $1,596.61 in the account to be used. Even at $500, that gives us only 3 years more of...
At the returns bill, right.
At the returns that we're getting.
Yeah.
Pays for something at Starbucks, so... I hate to say it, but I think we should reduce it once again. But we're not allowed to evade principal.
That is correct.
Just knowing, and I can appreciate your thoughts. And I guess every extra penny is valuable to the scholarship, so, you know, versus not giving something in 3 years or 4 years, whatever the case may be, not being able to give. Mm-hmm. So if we can stretch it out by reducing a little, okay, so you want to go to the 250, Carol?
Oh, I don't know. I just saw that we had reduced. So, well, I guess the question is how long a cushion do we want to have? Assuming interest rates aren't going to increase anytime soon. So if we move it to, 300.
Maybe 5 years.
That gives us 5 years.
You know what, I like that idea.
Five years.
Hopefully the economic outlook will be better for investments. 5 years out, no, 3 years out really, so it starts accumulating. So, do you want to make a motion for the $300?
Sure, I move that we fund the Luke Pfeiffer Scholarship for 2013 at $300.
So moved. All in favor? Aye. Okay, thank you. Our next agenda item is performance appraisals.
It's that time of year again, Mr. Dolly, where the Board of Selectmen authorizes us to set forth the process of preparing the performance reviews for various employees for the various departments.
Okay. And is it something we vote on, or you say?
It is something you vote on every year.
Thank you. Is there anything to be discussed on this?
No, I think just that it's a wonderful process. We're all familiar with it in the private sector, and it plays a very similar role in the public sector.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'll make the motion that we approve the performance appraisal
process.
For the fiscal 14, is that correct? The
Fiscal 13.
Fiscal 13. Yes. Yes. This isn't a wish list; it's an appraisal. Okay, I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Aye. Thank you. You know, this time of year, you wonder what year you're in. You know, whether
right.
It's tax returns, personal, business, government. Mm-hmm.
You know, these days I'm wondering what season I'm in.
Yeah, that's a good one. Okay, we're on to other business in the agenda, and we have two special licenses that we'll deal with first. The first on April 29th at, is that at Elm Bank? Yes, right. Mm-hmm. On April 23rd.
Yeah,
Mass what? Thank you. And the second is June 23rd at Elm Bank. I see the police chief has signed both of them. Very good. So I'll make the motion that we approve both special licenses. Do I hear a second?
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Thank you. Our next agenda item is reserve fund transfer for the water department. Mr. Ramsey, can you speak to that?
I can, Mr. Dolly. We're requesting $5,636 for expenses associated with the repair of a water service leak that occurred a week and a couple weeks ago on Center Street.
Okay. Good. Okay.
Is the reserve fund in good shape?
I was just going to ask that question.
Yes, the short answer is yes. It's had relative to the last fiscal year when there were more issues associated with the fuel tank. Yes, we've had relatively few calls on the call.
Yeah, this is either the second or third, if I recall.
Maybe just the second.
Yeah.
Knock on wood.
Knock on wood.
Exactly.
Yeah.
The year's not done, but so we're in very good shape, I think.
Oh, great.
Good. Okay, I'll make the motion that we approve the reserve fund transfer for $5,636 for the water department.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you. I don't think you signed
that. Oh, no, I don't.
Okay. Okay, the Pan Mass Challenge Kids Ride. Who would like to speak to that? I guess, you know what? I guess I can. Okay. I believe on Sunday, May 19th, in the morning, the Pan Mass Challenge Kids Ride in Dover and Sherburne. The opportunity for the children of Dover and Sherburne to get involved in supporting the PMC mission to fight cancer. I believe this will be the fourth year. It's raised more than $100,000, so it's done very well. And it's a truly wonderful community-wide event. So, they're looking for our support. And is this something we also have to approve, Dave?
Yes.
Thank you. Carol, do you have any questions on this?
Nope, great event.
Great. So I'll make the motion that we approve the Dover-Sherburne Pan Mass Challenge Kids Ride for Sunday, May 19th, 2013.
Second.
All in favor? Aye. Thank you. Chapter 90 reimbursements is our next agenda item. And Dave, I think, do you want to speak to this?
Certainly, Mr. Chairman. This is a reimbursement for a project previously authorized. A section of Main Street from Pleasant Street to Springdale Avenue.
Excellent.
Okay. I move we approve $94,881.
Second. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
For Chapter 9 reimbursement.
Yeah. Second. All in favor? Aye.
She's signing four places.
In four?
Yes.
Are the both of us signing four places?
Yes.
Okay, thanks. Okay. Under other businesses, yet another agenda item. It wasn't on the agenda, but Cal, you would like to respond to direct questions from our March 28th Board of Selectmen meeting.
Yes, thank
please.
You. Yep, thank you, Jim. There were two specific questions that were asked of the selectmen at the March 28th meeting, which was a meeting that good portion of it focused on the town election non-binding article about the Park and Rec project. And I have responded individually to the folks who asked the question, if I had their email, but I thought I should do it publicly as well, since there have been a lot of viewing of that meeting on YouTube and on cable. So one of the questions asked was, how much has Park and Rec paid Yale Associates? And according to our town accountant, since July 1st of 2009 to date, that amount is $70,414.01. The other question had to do with the conversation about having a non-binding question on the town election on May 20th without anything at town meeting to discuss it and present it. And we mentioned that in recent memory we had no example of that issue. So the question was asked as far as educating voters, how we might do that, and there was a wide discussion. One of the suggestions was that handouts be available for those that attend town meeting. And we've looked into that. It is a legal thing to do. The specifics of it are the responsibility of Jim Rapetti, the town moderator, and Barry Clough, the town clerk, the two elected officials who have authority over the town meeting. So they are working on logistical issues associated with that, and you can contact Barry Clough at some point in the town clerk's office for details, but handouts will be allowed at town meeting. Those are the two questions.
Good, thank you. Okay, I will open the floor to other citizens' comments, if you'd like. Well, before I adjourn, I just want to say a special thank you to Joe Melikin and, Carol's corrected me. Not the first time, I might add, but.
just took your glasses off too.
That's very true. We, on the next agenda item, we approve the March 28th meeting minutes, and which Carol just spoke of. It was a very good discussion regarding the CPARC non-binding ballot question. And this is a very tough meeting to put into minutes, but the office did a tremendous job in summarizing this.
We approve the minutes of March 28th.
So moved. All in favor? Aye. Thank
Aye.
You. Before I go to adjournment, I'd like to say thank you, Joe, very much. And I can't vouch for Carol, but all I have is water and toast to you, Joe.
Absolutely, toast to you. Maybe we'll all get together and toast it with something good.
With that, I'll make the motion for adjournment.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Good evening. Thank you.